Well, hello and happy Friday, everybody. I'm Erin Hull, and I am at the Reading Chamber of Commerce here with Jake Mingus, our president and CEO. And we're excited to talk today about a new program that the Chamber is launching this January. So, Jake, the Reading Chamber Candidates Academy.
That's right. Erin, this is a really exciting thing for us. We have made sure that we've reached out to our membership to say, what is it that you really are needing from us when it comes to local elections? And what we've heard from them loud and clear is they want information on the candidates. And we started thinking, okay, well, that kind of gets down the road a piece, but what does this really start with? And it starts with us doing an open invitation to people in the community that are considering running for office, or maybe they had it in their minds at one point, I wonder what it takes to run for office. Do I have what it takes? Where do I even begin? And we think that this Candidates Academy is that starting point for people to learn kind of the 101 about what it takes to run for office.
Sounds exciting. So tell us a little more about what it is. What's it going to look like? What's it going to be like?
So I will just say that we are going to have a great full day on a Saturday in January. And I know you're going to give those details in a bit. But what we want it to be is really a comprehensive look at everything from discovering your why for running, knowing the issues. How do you find out what the issues are out there for, you know, people who are living in the city, if you're running for city council, or if you're interested in serving the county of Shasta as a whole, what are county issues that you need to be aware of? What does it look like to develop your campaign team when it comes to actually disseminating the information or sharing your message and your platform out in the community? How do you do that in a way that is effective, and also knowing the rules around how you share information out? And then there are entities in the community that will be third-party advocates for you when you run for office, and how do you garner their support? So kind of from soup to nuts, we want them to know what it takes to make that fully discerned decision.
One of the topics is actually nuts and bolts. So nuts and bolts, soups and nuts, however you want to say it. But we know that this is going to be really informational for people. You don't have to have fully decided that you know you're going to run for office. If you want to explore the issue and maybe see if it's the right fit for you, this would be a great program to go through. So what else do you have to say about it?
I would say that sometimes, at least in my 6 years here at the Chamber, we feel like we are reactive to the people that decide that they want to run for office. And I think in this way, it's getting upstream and being proactive and actually inviting people in the community that, you know, have considered or are not sure if they want to run or not, getting those people the empowerment to actually step forward and know that they're not going at it alone. Right now, with the way that things are in our nation and how that trickles down to our community, in terms of, it's difficult to be an elected official these days.
It is.
So I think that as a result, good people have shied away from actually doing this.
Right.
It takes courage to do it, and we just want to give them that encouragement so that they can at least make that fully discerned decision, knowing that they're not alone, that there are organizations and people that are out there that really enjoy encouraging and supporting people that want to step up and serve their community.
I know I've heard myself from people that are interested in running, they just don't know where to begin. And a great place to begin sometimes, in some cases, is by helping on a campaign. So if there's somebody that you really believe in, you think they're gonna make a great leader within the community, it's great to get involved that way. And there's gonna be some information on how to do that well as well, right?
Yep, that is absolutely the case. This is not only for people that are considering running themselves, but also if you just wanna jump on board as a campaign chair or be a part of somebody's campaign, you can do that. So what are the details that people need to know about where, when, why, all this stuff?
Yeah, so it's going to be January 22nd. It's a Saturday. It's going to start at 9 a.m. And run through till about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. It's a four-part series. So one of the topics, for example, is, as Jake mentioned, know your why. Know why you're running. We know that this is important, but I will say from my experience, just in the time that I've been here at the Chamber, it's really opened my eyes to why it's important to have quality leaders, you know, leading our community and making decisions. And we just want to engage people in the best way that we know how, while kind of honoring the voice of our membership. So, so really encourage anyone who's at all interested to sign up. Lunch is going to be catered by Odell Craft Barbecue, which is one of our local favorites.
Delicious.
Here. So that's a great little added bonus in there. It's going to be right here at 1321 Butte Street downtown. And you can sign up on our website at readingchamber.com. You're just going to want to scroll down to the bottom and you'll see it there on the left-hand side of the screen. And there's some more information there as well as far as what are the topics going to be, who are the facilitators, and you'll be able to sign up right there. So we hope you do. Feel free to reach out if you have any questions or want some more information. And Jake, I'll just say I'm excited about this. I think it's going to be a really great way to approach governmental affairs moving forward for us.
I'm so excited about it as well. It really fills up my cup because we really want to be in touch with what our members are telling us they're wanting from us. And they're saying that they want information they can trust. They want us to help elect business-friendly candidates and represent their interests with local government.
Advocate for business-friendly policies.
Correct. Those are major things, big roles for us as an organization that we don't take lightly. We take them very seriously. So it does mean that we need to be involved in helping the development of candidates that are going to reflect the business perspective. We are promising our members that we're going to deliver that information to them so that they can make their own decisions when it comes to the election itself.
Yeah, there's some important years coming up here soon, and it'll be really fun to bring that information to the community.
And space is limited. I know we've got a few signups already, and we've got a capacity of about 15 or so in the room. So don't delay if you're interested. Sign up now. We look forward to seeing you there.
Thanks, Jake.
Yep. Thank you, Erin.
Have a great day, everybody.